Magic carpet across the ocean.
Okay, okay.
Damn, my love is never ending.
Okay.
Hey you guys, welcome to Fire Conversations with Keydra. I'm your host and I'm sitting here with the amazing, talented singer, songwriter, producer, JoshX. Thank you so much for sitting down with us today. We're gonna dive right into it because Josh has a lot going on. Let me ask you, what age did you start singing and playing the piano?
So, my mom being from the Caribbean, Haitian, she said, boy, we wasn't able to afford piano when she was growing up.
Right.
Because her parents were from Haiti and they didn't have the money to pay for the lessons.
Right.
So she said, when I have my own kids,
yeah,
you're going to play the piano.
Love it.
Or you're going to get kicked out. So me being smart,
right,
I said, I'm going to play the piano.
Right.
So I learned how to play at six.
That's
I was first introduced to classical music. So
right.
Mozart, Chopin was my first style of music that I've ever learned.
That's
before
crazy.
Even hip-hop and R&B.
Yeah.
And then at 13, I started getting into the ladies, you know, in schools, in high school, you start macking.
Right.
I started trying the piano with a little bit of vocal.
Yes.
And I was successful.
The ladies didn't know Mozart.
You feel me? They didn't know Mozart.
We didn't know Mozart.
That's how I switched.
Because
I dropped this classical piece on this girl's film. Mm-hmm. And by the time I opened my eyes, she was gone. So I told my moms, I got to go back to the drum room.
Right.
Yeah.
I love it. I'm not mad at it. Okay, so you worked with some, like, amazing talent. You worked with Cardi B. You worked with Rick Ross. Tell me, like, what that experience was like and who you had the most fun with out of everyone that you worked with.
Wow. First of all, I'm very thankful to be able to work with artists that I respect, and especially when they jump on my music.
Yeah.
Funnest artist to work with, I would say, is Jadakiss.
Ooh.
The reason why I go to Jadakiss, because he's so funny.
Yeah.
Dope. Show Me Love was the first person in the business to actually do a feature with me.
Wow.
So I was just really thankful for that. And then when I got a chance to go on some promo runs with him and meet him as a person,
yeah,
outside of the studio, he's just a funny guy, too.
That's dope, yeah. And he has that voice.
Yeah. Shout out to my guy, Jada.
I love it. Okay, so you know I was all stalking your gram. And I was reading your captions, and you had said that one of the songs you were writing, you found yourself, like, in the bed with your keyboard at, like, 4 a.m. writing. So talk to me about your writing process. Like, is that a regular for you?
Yeah, that is really a regular for me. I can't write on pen and paper.
Uh-huh.
It's just, for me, it doesn't come out from the heart. Like, I feel like I'm a freestyle, off-the-top kind of writer.
Yeah.
And I kind of like to be in my own vibe, in my own world, where everybody's asleep.
Yeah.
So I find myself writing some of my most meaningful songs in the wee hours of the morning.
Yeah, the world's quiet.
Yeah.
You can, like, really get
I
into
really
it.
I can really get into it. Do I ever cross your mind?
So again, I was stalking your gram, and I saw that you had, like, a crazy, like, weight loss journey that you've been, like, talking and sharing about. Can you tell us, like, what inspired that change, and, like, what did you do? Like, what are some tips? Were you, like, mad cardio? Were you juicing? Like, how'd you do it?
So I've been struggling with weight for a while,
mm-hmm,
since I got in the industry, and I didn't really understand it at first because I'm just like, I'm selling music.
Yeah.
You know, my music is what I want people to understand.
Yeah.
And then my father got diagnosed with colon cancer.
Oh, wow.
My stepfather. And when that happened, he was a healthy guy,
uh-huh,
and he got sick, and I was saying, dang, if I'm unhealthy,
yeah,
could the possibilities and the risk be even greater for me?
Right.
So it kind of woke me up in 2017 that I had to kind of just do it for myself and not for the industry, because I was comfortable with it myself.
Right.
I just wanted to be healthy.
Yeah.
So I went on this complete juicing diet.
Oh, cool.
In the beginning. Cut out all the rice, cut out all the fried foods,
that's
soda,
hard.
And
how
juice.
You know,
I mean, it just took so
like
much.
Fried food.
You feel me?
And the rice should be Asian.
Yeah, you feel me? The rice and the beans. So I said, the plantains. So I just said, let me just do this for my health.
Yeah.
And
sure.
I'm down 120 pounds.
That's amazing.
Yeah, thank you so much.
That's amazing. How'd that feel, like, when you just, like, got to that end? Like, what did that feel?
It feels good because, first of all, I lost, like, half of me. And then, second of all, it's just, like, I feel better.
Yeah.
Health-wise, breathing-wise, I can do more.
Every day.
Exercising-wise, my shows are greater, like, I can perform longer. And I didn't even realize how much, like, it was important.
Right.
So anybody that's out there for help, man, take it very seriously.
Heaven comes to my mind, girl, when I see your face.
Talk to me a little bit about your latest project, Piano Confession.
Yep.
What do you want the people to know about that project specifically?
I want that people to listen to it and find that it's the most honest project that I've personally ever created. And I've worked with so many artists, I've written for so many artists.
Yeah.
And I tried to, when I was with Stevie Wonder, he made me make him a promise to write songs and put out music that can help people's lives.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
And to me, I took that as something really special because as an entertainer, I feel like my job is to help you overcome something, whether it's happiness, get married, fall in love, deal with heartbreak, deal with heartache, deal with struggles of life. And Piano Confessions was my personal struggle with life, love, family, not understanding the divorce of my parents, what that played in my life. So I want people to get a lesson, to learn a lesson about life and how you can go through things and overcome them.
Right.
And you don't have to take the shortcuts. You don't have to drop out of school.
Yeah.
I finished college. You don't have to get into any trouble. You
can
do everything by the books. Handle your struggle. Believe in God and you'll be all right.
No,
so that's what
it's
about.
Yeah, no, I love that. There's definitely a vibe project. You know, right now the state of R&B is a little different, but I feel like you took it back to like the original form. It's smooth. It's so, you know what I'm saying? You
Thank
feel
you.
Something.
Thank you so much.
That was dope. Bro. I like it.
Thank you.
Okay, so do you think that, you know, we out on this rooftop? I don't know what these acoustics are like, but can we get you to sing a little something whatever you want. Whatever you want.
Pillow tight, late night, wait by your phone. You get some snacks.
Hey.
Before you wake up, I'll be home by the morning.
Hey.
You know a nigga work hard, so I'm always in my zone.
Yeah,
okay, yeah. I've been a dog since day one, so I'm quick to catch a bone.
Ooh.
I know you're looking for love. Girl, you gotta trust me. I'm the one with the ones. You should come and get you some. I got plenty money. I know I built this for us. Girl, you gotta trust me.
Hey.
I'm all that you need, girl. Let's look up to the stars, girl. We could really go far. We gonna work hard today so we can chill tomorrow. Put it on me, yeah.
So you know the two? We all about opinions. You know, we start a little drama sometimes.
Let's
you know, with our questions, but let me ask you.
Uh-huh.
Okay, you on a desert island. We not on this Fivescape right now. We on a desert island.
Yeah.
And you love R&B music. You appreciate vocals. You get one CD, one. It's either Whitney or it's Mariah. You only get one. You only take one with you. The boat only allowed one CD.
I'm going to take Whitney.
You going to take Whitney?
I'm going to take Whitney.
Yes, okay, because she has no pipes. Okay. I saw you a fly guy in the video with Rick Ross. I saw you had like the Gucci shoes on. So I had to ask you. I love that when you were like hitting on that. The pedal.
On a pedestal.
I loved it. So let me ask you. J's or Nikes? You wearing sneakers?
J's
all day?
Yeah.
Where do you spend most of your time? Is it Twitter or is it on the gram?
I spend most of it on the gram.
On the gram, right? The gram is popping. All right. If you eating chicken, you know we eat healthy, but you eat chicken sometimes. So
if
we doing that, are we doing flats or are we doing drums?
We gonna do flats. We just did some flats the other day.
Yes, flats all day. And then I'm gonna ask you this one, Da Baby or Lil Baby?
Lil Baby.
I love it. Thank you so much for sitting down with us.
Thank you for
this
having me.
This is Josh X. He has a new project out right now. Where can we find it?
You can find that on every platform, Apple Music, Spotify, Tidal. Make sure you listen to it. Learn to, you know, appreciate it. It's from the heart. It's your boy, JoshX.